It's not over yet. They're coming after us. Fuck! Lose them!
Suspect is about 6 feet tall, dark hair, medium build. Down four.
What the fuck was that, Henry?
No idea. Somebody else must have known about the deal. Those definitely weren't real cops.
Maybe it was the Chinks trying to fuck us.
I doubt it. Look, I'll figure it out. But first, we gotta unload this stuff. Vito, take us to the old warehouse in Hunters.
Alright. Hope this deal goes better than the last one.
It will. Not like it can go any worse, right?
So who are we selling the stuff to?
A bunch of different guys.
Oh, whoa. What do you mean, a bunch of different guys?
A bunch of different guys. What did all that shooting back there make you deaf?
I thought you said we were just moving this garbage from one place to another.
Yeah, well, you make a lot more money if you sell it in smaller amounts.
Would have been really nice to know before I agreed to go in on this.
If I did, from the way you were talking back in the park, you probably wouldn't have.
Yeah, exactly.
Hey, the best you can hope for right now is to spend the next 30 years of your life breaking your ass for Eddie and Carlo before you either get bumped off or end up back in the can. The only time you're ever gonna see cash like this is if you stick your neck out. Besides, I ever steer you wrong?
Well, there was the OPA job. And that time we almost got killed when we whacked that fat fucking Sand Island.
All right, enough. None of that matters after today. Let's just get the Hunters. And don't worry, we're never gonna have to see these scumbags again after today.
Unless this turns into a regular thing for us.
Well, all right, let's just concentrate on getting through this one before we go making plans like that, all right?
Hey, I'm just saying.
Vito's right. Let's just get through the rest of the day. After that, smooth sailing, fellas.
Let me do the talking. These are tough guys, so no wise-ass comments. All right, Joe? Hey, guys, how you doing?
Hey, man. Come on in.
Shit! It's smoke!
Did it! We hit the jackpot!
Hey, take it easy. We're not done yet.
Lighten up, will you, Henry? What's the matter? All of a sudden, money don't make you happy?
After we pay back Bruno and you get your cut, then you could be happy.
All right.
You ain't even gonna give me a tip?
You want a tip? I'll give you a tip. Don't let the door hit you in the ass on the way out.
Always the gentleman, huh, Joey?
Just...
Barbaro's bordello. You got the money, we got the honeys.
Vito, it's Henry. We got a problem.
What kind of problem?
Eddie paid me a visit. Carlo knows about the deal, and he sent Eddie to pick up his cut.
How much?
$60,000.
Fuck, that much? What are we gonna do?
I don't know. We don't even have enough left for Bruno. Meet me in the park. I don't want to talk about this over the phone.
Okay. I'll be right there. Joe, we gotta go.
What? What for?
Now, Joe. I'll tell you on the way.
All right. Girls, lock up when you leave. Me and Vito got business. So what the hell's going on?
That was Henry on the phone. Carlo found out about the deal.
Ah, shit! Does he know he was involved?
I don't think so. Let's talk about it in the car.
Where we headed?
Lincoln Park.
We meeting Henry there?
Yeah.
All right, so what did Henry say on the phone? He okay?
Sounded okay. But Carlo took his car to the take.
Fuck. Just like Henry said he'd do if he found out.
Yeah, but now the problem is, we don't even got enough to pay Bruno back.
Ah, shit. What the hell are we gonna do?
In pursuit of a hit-and-run driver.
We get to the park.
Oh. Yeah.
Copy
that. Henry'll know what to do.
Some guy here just assaulted an officer.
Roger that.
Henry's different these days. Guy's got a real... What the fuck's
going on? Shit, that's Henry.
What the fuck are they hitting him with?
Get on me!
Going in!
Let's go, Vito.
Come out of your hole, you fucking rat.
Pues ando, le Vito.
Fuck! Who the fuck does something like this, Vito? Them people are fucking sick. Shit! Who the fuck does something like this?
What do you think?
God damn it, Henry! Damn it, Henry!
Look at this, Vito.
Of all the ways to kill a guy, goddamn bullet would have been enough.
These bastards are sick in the head, Vito. They're gonna fucking die. All of them.
I mean, why do it like that? And in the middle of the park.
Like I said, they're sick. I'm gonna turn them into chop fucking suey.
Not for nothing. We don't even know how many of them there are.
Yeah, and it don't matter.
Henry's dead. What, do you want us to get killed too? You gotta be smart, Joe.
It don't matter how we do it. As long as they're fucking dead when we're done.
All right, listen. There's probably more to two of them.
So what? The more the fucking merrier.
So there's only two of us. Unless maybe you want to call Carlo and tell him all about the mess we're in and ask him to send some guys over here.
All right, fine.
Oh, what's where do you go?
So promise me you're not gonna go in guns blazing as usual. We gotta do this the smart way, all right? I'm doing the best I can. Find him.
Let's get in there and take him out before he disappears with the money.
Hold on, I'm gonna need some serious firepower first.
We can either go to Harry's or we can kill these fucks right now. Just say the word.
Down while you were at it.
Pipe down!
Stop wasting these little fucks!
Get the asshole behind the bar!
Wait, my fuck!
They hung up!
Go, hang up!
Take them out quick, Nito! We gotta find one!
This is for Henry, you bastard!
Die, you piece of shit!
Give up now!
Watch out! They shoot from up top! Vito, let's move up!
So he's on Cuyo!
Get the guy on the stairs! Come on, how do you like that, man?
Jose, Homa!
Up there, in the window!
You ain't so tough!
Say goodnight, jolly kid.
What? Don't laugh.
China around.
With the wrong guys, didn't you? All right, you go first, Vito. You're a smaller target.
Thanks, if that is.
Hey, you said we gotta do this smart, right? Some of these little bastards for me. Where the hell is that prick?
He's got to be around here somewhere. Let's keep going.
Don't matter, I got plenty of bullets.
more to go. That's it. Quiet, Vito.
Since when are you concerned about making noise?
There's too many of them. Just take them out nice and quiet. Are you deaf or what? I said we should be quiet.
Ne conte, Homa.
I'm gonna get you sooner or later. Back me up, Vito. You're fucking dead! Let's go, Vito. Come on, think of something. Hurry up here. I'm back. Yeah.
Vito!
The last of them. See? Ain't so bad so far, right?
Yeah, but what if somebody recognizes us and Carlo hears about it?
That's why we ain't leaving no witnesses. There's probably more of them down here. Get ready.
You're dead, you slanty-eyed fuck!
What is it that you want?
What the fuck do you think?
Looks like this place won't be opening up for a while.
If we had the time, I'd burn it to the damn ground.
Vito, come here. This should be the way out.
Where you going, Vito? That's the way we came in.
Ah, fuck this! Come on, Vito, let's get out of here. There's too many of them. Find us a car, quick!
This guy's a maniac! We gotta take him down! 10-4.
He's scared as hell!
Oh, it is. Shut the fuck.
All right. We lost him.
Screaming from within. We've got no more details right now, but stay tuned.
Take me to my place, Vito. I need a fucking drink.
That was, was fucked up, huh?
Yeah. I don't want to talk about it. Just get me back to my place, would you?
All right.
Suspect is about 6 feet tall, dark hair, medium build. Copy that.
Hear that whistle, it's 10 o'clock. Come on, baby, it's time to rock.
The idea is to not run over.
That came out of nowhere.
I'm so happy I got you here. Keeps me
real. Are you trying to hit every fucking car?
Hey, I know how to drive, all right?
This feeling's killing me.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're sorry to have to cut into our regular rock and roll programming, but we bring you news of a massive shootout in progress at the Red Dragon restaurant in Chinatown. Now, police are on the scene, and shots continue to be fired from inside the Red Dragon restaurant. The streets in that corner of Chinatown are crowded with onlookers and patrons who fled the shootout.
This deal was a total fucking disaster.
Tell me about it.
Henry's dead. We don't have Bruno's money. We killed half the Tongs. And if they think Carlo sent us, that'll mean war. We're fucked.
Yeah. And if Carlo finds out we got him into this mess...
What if Henry really was a rat?
No fucking way. Don't even say that. Look, first let's get the money for Bruno. That'll fix at least one problem. But I'm done for today. I need a drink. I'll call you in the morning. We'll figure this shit out.
All right.
Okay.
Sound like I'm ready? You just woke me up.
So get the fuck up. We don't get the money for Bruno today. We're fucked.
Where the hell are we gonna get our hands on 55 grand, huh?
I don't know. We sure as hell ain't gonna find it laying around in bed. I got something for starters. A job from Eddie with a big payout.
No shit?
Yeah, I'll pick you up in a few minutes. So get dressed, grab a gun, and wait for me outside. I'll tell you more in the car.
This better not be one of your brilliant ideas, Joe.
Hey, I'm not in the mood.
Sorry. Didn't mean to snap at you. I'm still half asleep over here.
Yeah, whatever. So you in or not?
Sure, why not? How long till you get here?
I'm calling from the gun shop around the corner. I'll be at your place in a minute.
All right, I'll wait for you out back. I'll see you soon. With the fancy wheels.
Eddie gave it to us just for this job. Nice, huh? You drive. My head's still pounding from last night. We're going to Greenfield.
Guess you hit the sauce pretty hard, too, huh?
Yeah, I couldn't sleep either. Nothing a bottle of scotch couldn't fix, though. Head over to Greenfield.
All right. So now can you tell me what this is all about?
We're just gonna drive there, pop some guy, and drive away. Should be a piece of cake.
Why?
Eddie said it's a favor for some family from another city. Unfinished business. He gave me this envelope with all the instructions. Said it's gotta be clean, and it's gotta be done today.
Why the hell doesn't the other family just do it themselves?
Eddie said they've been looking for this guy for a while, and he just found him. They're afraid that if it ain't done right away, the guy's gonna disappear. Here, here's a picture.
What'd this guy do?
Says here he ratted his family out to the feds.
Guy's got it coming to him, man. But wait, if he cooperated with the feds, that means he was under protection, right? What if he still is?
Even if he is, we're getting paid a few grand for the job. So it's more than worth the risk.
If you say so.
Hey, we need every penny we can get right now, right? So after we finish this job, we'll split up and look for other work.
All right.
Says here they want us to give him a message before we do it. Here it is.
Okay, got it.
Hey, if you see Eddie later, not a word about yesterday. He was never there. Last chink we saw was delivering egg foo young. You get it?
Yeah, you think I am some kind of retard?
Jury's still out on that one, pal. Just making sure you don't slip up, that's all.
Drive like my fucking grandmother, you know that?
10-4.
You're gonna kill somebody you keep driving that way. I'm gonna find you.
Thank you, officer.
Do yourself a favor, pal, and straighten up.
Gotta say?
Yeah.
All right. Here we go then.
Mr. Angelo.
Yes?
Mr. Salieri sends his regards.
Like I said,
he's okay. Dark hair, medium build.
Those guys over there.
Shit! Go, go!
We got a homicide here. Suspect is armed.
This is Agent Cox. Report in Greenfield. Now, goddammit!
Those were feds. That asshole really was under protection.
And he's famous for conveniently leaving out little details like that.
Maybe he didn't know. Don't matter now. We gotta lose him. Oh, fuck. That was close. Get me to Kingston, will you? I got a car waiting there.
What about the money?
Hey, I almost forgot. Eddie paid me in advance, so here's your share. Good luck getting your half of the money. Come by my place when you're done.
Okay. I'll see you later.
suspect is about 6 feet tall, dark hair, medium build.
Roger that.
Yes, baby. Shake it, baby. Shake it, baby. Shake it, baby. One time. Come on, baby. Oh, yeah.
Go now?
Hello, sir. Good to see you this afternoon.
Bring up on me.
Hey.
Vito! Hey, thanks for coming by. I knew I could count on you.
What for?
Frank's organizing a sit-down with the other bosses, and he took almost all my guys as bodyguards. So I don't have nobody around to handle this here job for me.
Derek, these guys still don't want to work.
What? Why?
Because of that deadbeat you fired.
Hey.
Shit. Well, Vito, that other thing will have to wait. Can you help us out here with this first?
What's happening?
Well, this deadbeat didn't come to work for a whole week, pretending he was sick. Total bullshit. So I fired his ass. Anyway, some of his buddies are upset, and they're threatening to strike. All I gotta do is show up with a few guys who look like they mean business. That'll scare them, and they'll forget all about it. I give you $1,000. Are you in?
All right. I ain't gonna say no to that kind of money.
All right. All you need is... These fucking guys really think who the fuck they are. This ain't the first time I have problems with them, you know.
Know how many of them there is?
3, 4, 10. How the fuck should I know? Does it matter?
Oh, nah, it's just, what are we gonna do to them?
All depends on how the, labor negotiations go. Just let me do all the talking. I don't need you just opening your mouths and proving how stonard you are. So, what's the problem here, fellas?
We want you to give Big John his job back.
It's me that decides who gets hired and fired around.